I do need a name. Again, this is a Suriname True Red Tail Boa Constrictor. Oh yeah, that was a responsible purchase, Laura. Hey, good morning, everybody. Welcome to the vlog. Is your day starting out amazing? I know mine sure is. I get to spend this time here at BHB, but we are going on a couple trips. As a matter of fact, the next month and a half is gonna be pretty insane, and I'm gonna talk to you guys about it and see what you guys think. But regardless, today, Lori is gonna be feeding colubrids. I have a bunch of little busy work to do. I don't know, we're gonna find our way through it, but we're gonna make it absolutely incredible. What do you say that us together make this an amazing day? For the next 12 or 15 minutes, just set all your problems aside and just have a good time watching us, enjoying our life, being around these amazing animals. Can you do me a favor right now? Can you hit that like button? Let's get this video up to as many likes as possible, as well as make a comment. I love reading your guys' comments, and I interact with you guys as much as I possibly can. Regardless, gonna be an amazing day. Let's go ahead and get it started. So before I get this day kind of on the road and seeing what's gonna happen, which I'm gonna be completely honest with you, today's gonna be a kind of a weird day because there's just a lot of crazy stuff going on, and I don't have any one major thing. So a lot of times in the vlog, there's usually like one major thing going on, like, you know, whether I feed the big snakes or I'm cleaning something or packing or doing whatever the case may be. Today is just kind of all over the place. My mind is out of control, so it's going to be a fun day, but who knows what this vlog is going to be about. Regardless, a lot of people have asked recently about Sunrise because, you know, now that I'm getting more and more pets like Verde and Perdita and Bowser and RJ and the list goes on, Bella, it's not that easy to get everybody in the vlog all the time. Don't worry, when you don't see something for a little while, it doesn't mean like anything happens. If anything does happen to something, I promise I'll share it with you guys. Regardless, Sunrise is an animal that a lot of people have asked about. You can see, look at how big she's getting. Oh my gosh, she is just such an amazing animal, and she's been feeding like a champ, and she's still her complete sweetheart self. I just love her so much, and I mean, isn't it amazing how big she's getting? I mean, every time I look at her, I'm like, oh my gosh. And that's what happens with Burmese pythons, is they kind of get to that size when they start to eat bigger meals, and then when they start to eat bigger meals, they really grow rapidly. She's actually at that size where pretty soon she'll start taking little, like maybe 2 pound rabbits. And that's when they literally go from, you know, 6, 6.5 foot where she is now to 8 or 10 foot within a matter of like 4 or 5 months. So she is on the cusp of being a big snake, and I could not be more excited about it. Regardless, I just wanted to update you on Sunrise. She is beautiful, she's doing great. Thank you for being concerned and asking. I will do my best. As a matter of fact, down in the comments, you can let me know how should I kind of update you guys. I don't want to bore you guys with always saying, oh, here's this, here's that. But at the same time, I want you guys to understand what's going on with my beautiful animal ambassadors here. So let me know what you guys think. Of course, you guys remember I got this amazing Suriname Red Tail Boa from my friends in Chicago. Thank you guys so much. This was amazing. And this was just a gift to me. They had production and they said that if they produced, they wanted to give me one. And I am so excited to have her. But with that said, I do need a name. Again, this is a Suriname True Red Tail Boa Constrictor, and these guys get a little bit bigger than the common boas typically, and of course they have that brilliant tail. So I am so excited, but this girl needs a little name. So could you comment down below and let me know what this beautiful girl should be named? Look at her, she is so awesome. I cannot wait till she is 8 or 9 feet long. She's gonna be incredible. But you know, a lot of the true red tails, in particular Surinames, need to be fed a little bit lighter than say a common boa. So you don't want to give these guys big meals because they have tender stomachs, in the sense that if you give this too large of a meal, they could regurgitate. And then if it regurgitates, they get something that's called chronic regurgitation syndrome, and they can die. So you have to feed them a little bit less than you would a normal boa, but eventually they get much larger. So let me know what name you think this girl should be. Lori does the majority of the packing of snakes when it comes to shipping, but of course when she gets busy, which she has to feed a bunch of snakes, I'm called to duty. And today I have 5 or 6 ball pythons going out, so I have to just find them and hopefully be able to pack them in time for FedEx to get here. I've got about 15 minutes and I'm pretty slow at this. So what I mean by bad at this is that I hate packing snakes. I've told you guys that before. I just don't like sending snakes out. And then also it's kind of hard to find everything because it's kind of not, again, it's organized chronologically, not alphabetically. Pretty soon, now that we're almost done hatching, we'll rearrange everything into alphabetical and then it makes it super easy. But what happens is, let's say this one here is a banana, but it's an M06. So we probably have 8 or 10 animals up on the website and I've got to find the exact one that they want, because that's why we do that. When you buy an animal off our website, you get the animal that is there, not some just generic animal. So anyways, I have to find all these snakes, so wish me luck. And here's the first little guy right here. Take a look at how gorgeous that is. This is actually a desert ball python. And they're either incomplete dominant or co-dominant, but we're not 100% sure. And the reason for that is that, believe it or not, this amazing animal here, females don't reproduce, so we don't know if there's a super version because you can't breed a male and a female together to get a potential super. When these first came out and people thought there might be a super or we thought they'd be co-dominant, whatever the case is, these guys were selling for like $7,500 a piece. Now the males can reproduce and they're absolutely awesome and make some beautiful babies. The females are basically just really pretty pets. Regardless, they just clean up amazingly. Next up is an oldie but a goodie. This is a bumblebee ball python. It's a pastel spider. I tell you what, when bumblebee ball pythons were first produced by Kevin McCurley, I was blown away. I thought it was the most beautiful snake I had ever seen. So still all these years later, I think they're absolutely amazing. I mean, just take a look at that animal. I mean, that thing is stunning. Yeah, I gotta tell you guys, there's probably not a day that doesn't go by that we don't ship out at least one banana ball python. Look at how gorgeous these guys are. Now that they're pretty inexpensive, my gosh, people love banana ball. I love banana ball pythons. And I think if you're gonna have a pet snake, I mean, that it's hard to find something more beautiful than that, don't you think? So again, almost every day we ship out at least one banana, if not two or three. So we sell so many of these. Oh my gosh, we need to produce some more. But anyways, that is a beautiful banana. Ooh, doggy. I tell you what, we're talking about bananas. Look at this little monkey here. This, of course, is a banana pinstripe. And oh my gosh, this one is on fire. I mean, that thing is ridiculous. It's like you need sunglasses to look at that animal. Oh my gosh, banana pinstripe. Okay, so we can't find the last animal. I'm gonna go upstairs and see what's going on because either they might have mismarked it. Sometimes they give me the wrong list. Okay, so I went upstairs. Sure enough, it is a black pewter. Lori is looking for it and see, you found it?
Yes, I did find it. You're the worst. Literally, just like my kids, open your eyes. Look again with your eyes open, Brian.
I looked, Mary looked, it was Mary's fault.
Don't you dare put that on Mary.
Is that true? I looked on this side. Mary looked on that side.
Towards the bottom.
It was my fault. So, all right. So, done packing for the day. Thank you, Lori.
So, today I'm back at feeding again, like I do every day, or so it feels. But one thing I am feeding today are the baby rhino rats, and those are a little bit different. These feed on fish. So that is what we do, is we put fish in the little cups, and then those little cups will go into their cages. So it makes it pretty easy. I put a few fish in a thing and I just set them in there like that. And believe it or not, these little guys will crawl up in there and they will eat them. So I'm just gonna throw those in there right now, and then I will check them before I leave at the end of the day to make sure if they fed or not. They usually eat them literally within a few minutes. But while they're doing that, I have to feed the adult colubrids. Okay, well, I'm halfway done with feeding now. Flipping around to the other side. Gotta rock this stuff out because even though this is a big part of what I have to do today, I still have a lot of other things to do.
You know, Lori always gets on me for going and buying stuff, whether it's shoes or snakes or other things. But what does Lori do? She goes to the store and what does she do?
What did you do?
What is that?
I got dog costumes. And don't give me crap about buying stuff because this is amazing. Look it, Artie is going to be a cup of coffee and Zeusie is going to be a freaking dinosaur.
Well, my number one, all right, this gives me a free pass to go do something.
No, it does not. These were 60% off. They were very cheap.
Oh yeah, that was a responsible purchase, Laura.
Shut up.
And the other thing is Artie will never wear that costume.
She's gonna love it.
Artie, look at her. She is not
we'll
gonna
We'll do
wear
Zeus first.
Okay. Zeusie, you so
he's
excited.
He's excited. See, he's like, what is this? Let's
he's
put
so
it on.
Excited.
Yeah. Here. Oh my god, look at it. There's Don't ear worry. Holes. There's
You can put it in your
Oh shirt. My god, this is so amazing. Oh my god, my day is so much better.
Zeusie, you're a dinosaur.
Oh, you're so cute.
Oh my god.
You're so cute.
did you get one for Artie too?
I did.
Yes.
You're so cute.
Are you going trick or treating, Zeus? You've been going trick or treating.
He's happy.
All right, so Zeus cooperated pretty good. I'm kind of surprised, to be honest with you. Artie, I don't think it's going to be as easy.
She'll do anything for me. Won't you, girl? I'm going to hate the hat. That's a given. But she's going to do it because she loves me.
Artie, come here. Artie.
You're so pretty.
Come here.
You're so pretty.
Arts.
No, she won't look. She's embarrassed.
She's mad. She's got that mad look on her.
I love you too. You're the cutest cup of coffee ever.
Susie, come over here. All right. So we got the dinosaur Susie. We got the cup of coffee man Artie. Guys, let me know down in the comment which one you like better. Do you like Zeus the dinosaur or the upset Artie? Let me know down in the comments, guys, what you think. Okay, Lori, you've got some more explaining. I mean, you go to the store and you buy a bunch of crazy dog stuff, and now what is this? What exactly is this here? It looks like a coffee cup and a wine cup on the other side. What the heck are you doing?
I did not buy this. This was a gift.
A gift from who?
A gift from Jen. Like, Jen. And actually, I'm going to say, like, she kind of hit the nail on the head. How awesome is this?
What does it say? Before five
is coffee. After five is wine.
Oh, my gosh. Jen, what are you doing, Senator?
Perfect. I'm going to start tonight with the wine.
I thought for sure that she had bought that. I was like, oh, my God. I was literally going to go out and buy a pair of shoes just to spite you.
You know what? Would you stop it? Like, you need a reason.
That's true. Okay, you're off the hook right. This time. I'll let you off the hook this time. But I tell you, I gotta keep an eye on her. I tell you, she's just something else. All right, so guys, I just got a call from Noah, and he's like, Dad, get home because I've got a video idea. And whenever I hear Noah has a video idea, I think to myself, all right, what am I gonna get beat up by, have to eat gross, whatever? I have no idea, but it's always a lot of fun. The truth is, guys, we love spending time together. Myself, Lori, Noah, we love making his videos because they're always funny and they're so much fun. So I'm sure it's gonna be a good time. I will let you know what it's all about. I'll also put a link down in the description to his channel and that video. Please show him some love and support. I can't thank you guys enough. So I am gonna go ahead and get out of here and head home and see what's going on and have some fun with Noah. So I am just home, and I think this doesn't seem like a bad choice at all from Noah. We got some pumpkins, so it looks like we're just gonna carve some pumpkins. I mean, what? That's not bad at all, right? I mean, that's what we're just much. Carving pumpkins?
Yeah, this is a little twist.
A twist? What twist?
It's not the most family friendly carving.
What the heck is he talking about, Lori?
I have no idea.
Noah.
What? You'll have to find out.
Another bad choice.
Link in bio.
Alright, listen, I have no idea what the heck this means, but I will put the link in the description. Make sure to check it out. I'll see you guys on the other side, probably absolutely mortified with what we're about to do. So you may notice that I am freshly showered, my hair is wet. That's because what Noah did to me is ridiculous. Go ahead and click the link on the description. You can see the whole thing. It was absolutely hilarious. We had a great time, definitely fun, but it definitely took a really bad turn at the end, and I ended up pretty messed up. Regardless, it was fun, and thank you guys so much for tuning in today. You guys mean the world to me. I hope that you have an amazing day, morning, night, whatever it might be. Can you do me a couple favors? Can you smash that like button and hit that notification bell? Remember to be kind to somebody, and I promise I'm gonna see you guys tomorrow.